Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Hema, and if you're new to my channel, I make videos on motherhood, arts and crafts, travel and photography. And this video is all about tips for breast pumping. So first thing is flange size, and throughout your pumping journey, your flange size is going to vary. And try not to use a small one or a large one, just use the one that fits for you at that time. Because if you use either a very small one or a very large one, it can lead to clogged milk ducts, and again, which can lead to pain and inflammation and other things. So first thing is make sure to use the right flange size. Next thing is hand massage. When you're breast pumping, it's also a good idea to hand massage, because hand massage will increase the milk flow. Next thing is change the walls frequently. So those duckbill walls are actually what create that suction. Make sure to replace them frequently, because if they're not functioning well, then they will not extract enough milk from the breast, and that can again lead to pain and inflammation and engorgement. Know that there are adapters. So there are wide neck bottles and the narrow neck bottles. It's always a good idea to pump into the bottles which you're going to feed directly to the baby. When it comes to different brands, all brands have different kinds of bottles. However, the trick is to remember that there are adapters which will help you convert those narrow neck bottles to wide neck and wide neck to narrow neck. And you can purchase those adapters from Amazon and other places, because those adapters will really help you in converting the wide neck to the narrow neck bottles. Next thing is inner side of backflow protectors and tubing. They do not need to be sterilized. And as I mentioned in my previous video, please do check the previous video if you have not checked, because these are all created in a sequence, so you'll not be able to understand this video without following my previous video. So if you check my previous video on breast pumping, I mentioned several times that you need to know how to use your breast pump before your delivery. And even if you don't know exactly how to use a breast pump, have an idea of how it functions. Another trick is you can save the pump parts between the pump sessions in a Ziploc bag. Try to buy those 1 gallon Ziploc bags, and you don't need to wash your pump parts every single time. So what I used to do is, say for example, in an 8 hour period, I'm pumping say 3 times. All those 3 times between those sessions, after every time I pumped, I save all the pump parts in the Ziploc bags. I don't even separate them. I take the whole piece as is and put them in the Ziploc bag, and then save it in the refrigerator for my next use. So in this way, I used to reuse the bottles for almost 8 hours. But again, you have to be very careful when you're doing this. You cannot exceed more than 8 hours. And this is a lifesaver, because you will go crazy if you're washing after every single breast pump. And also, breast milk can be saved at room temperature for 4 hours. So right after you pump, if you leave the breast milk outside for 4 hours, you can still feed to the baby. It's still safe. If you're leaving it in the fridge, then you have to leave it in the back of the fridge where it is the coldest, and you can leave them in the fridge for up until 4 days. And if you're saving in the freezer, again, you have to save it in the back of the freezer. And if you do that, then you can save the breast milk for almost 12 months. And when you take the breast milk back from the freezer, you have to let them thaw in the fridge for 24 hours. Once you get the packet from the freezer, you can use it up to 24 hours after thawing. And once you warm the milk, then you have to use it within 12 hours. Again, I'll leave all these instructions on the screen for you to see. Always try to have 2 or more sets. I personally had 4 sets because I was an exclusive pumping mother. The more sets you have, the more easier it is for you. Otherwise, you're always running around looking for parts. And until 3 months, it's always recommended to sterilize all parts. And also another tip is, if you have seen my newborn essentials video, I mentioned in that video about the dishwashing rack. Please buy that if you're able to, because that is a lifesaver. I did the mistake of washing all the pump parts every single time manually, and that was a big mistake. If I have a choice to redo my pumping journey, what I would have done is just thrown everything in the dishwasher and all those small parts in the dishwashing rack, and that's going to save a lot of time and mental and emotional burden on you. Because pumping is the easy part, but after that, washing all those pumping parts can be a pain. Try to use a dishwasher and a dishwasher rack if you can, because that will save you a lot of hassle. And one thing that I want to say on camera is that no one is born a mother, but you become a mother. So don't put all this undue pressure on you that you have to be a certain way or know everything. That is not true. You're not born a mother, you become a mother, and it's a process, and you have to allow yourself to go through the process, and that includes all the emotions, the highs, the lows, and everything in between. So next question is, can you mix milk from 2 different settings? So do not do that. And if you want to do that, what you can do is, so say for example, if you have pumped into 2 bottles the first time, mix those two into one bottle and leave this bottle in the refrigerator. And in your next sitting, again, if you're formed into two bottles, you can merge them into one and then leave that in the refrigerator. Now, after they've cooled to the same temperature, now you can mix those two bottles because they're in the same temperature. When it comes to breast pumping, frequency is very important. You will be able to keep up your supply if you keep the same frequency even though you're pumping for less time. So frequency is very important when it comes to breast pumping. So when I asked doctor if it's okay to give cold milk to the baby, then they said that you can give cold milk to the baby, but personally I think it's good to at least warm up the milk a little bit. Also, when you save milk in refrigerator, you will see that the milk will separate into the liquidy part and the fat part. The fat part floats on the top and the watery part stays in the bottom. So when you warm the milk, everything blends in. But otherwise, if your milk is slightly cold but you still want to feed the baby, then make sure that you gently mix it. Don't shake it vigorously, be gentle with the milk. And also, when you store the milk for too long, then there is something called as lipase that gets formed. And sometimes baby reject that milk which is stored in the freezer for too long because there can be high lipase formation. So personally, I wouldn't recommend buying a bottle warmer, especially in countries where you have access to hot water at any given time. So you can just grab some warm water from the sink and then just put the milk in there for it to thaw. And it's always good to air dry your pump pads. You can also use a wet or dry pumping pads bag. So this is the one that I have. So this is very useful if you want to carry dry or wet pumping pads together. This is not a must, but if you're someone who gets tired of using Ziploc bags all the time and want to choose an eco-friendly option. Another important piece, especially for working mothers, is to watch baby photos or baby videos when you're pumping, because that also helps you boost your milk supply. There is a lot of societal pressure regarding breastfeeding, but people often forget that mothers are also human beings. And as mothers, even though we do our best, we often tend to feel guilty. So don't let anyone trip you into feeling guilt, because as mothers, you always want to do the best for your child. And remember, always keep track of your total milk supply in a day. It's helpful because your milk supply is going to vary between each day. And also the color of your milk is going to vary between each day based on what food you have consumed. And it also depends on your stress levels. It depends on how often you're pumping and so many other factors. So don't expect your milk supply to be the same throughout. And it's okay if you give a bottle on days when you're not able to pump. And for you to get more milk, you also have to drink a lot of fluids. So do not ignore your fluid intake. In case you have decided to take the exclusive pumping route, don't start with a big goal thinking that you're going to pump for 2 years or 3 years or 4 years. Instead, take it in small bits. Start with 6 months or say 3 months, and then you do 6 months, then you do 1 year, and then you do 1.5 year or 2 years, however longer you want. So the best way for you to stay motivated is to keep your goals small in the initial phases. I initially wanted to do 2 years, but then by 9 months I was almost done, and somehow I pushed myself for 1 year, and that's when I went cold turkey and I just stopped pumping. And every time I wanted to stop, I would feel guilty and I would just say to myself, just one more week, and I just kept pushing myself to do it for 1 year. So keep small goals so that you're not overwhelmed. And it's also important to be flexible. There will be a point where you just feel like you cannot take it anymore, then you can stop. And there are cases where you may not be able to establish breastfeeding, and that is totally okay. There is a bright side to that too. You can spend more time with your baby, which you don't get if you're constantly feeding them and taking care of them. You cannot get those quiet moments with the baby. So don't be hard on yourself if you're unable to establish direct breastfeeding, because in my case, my schedule did not match with baby's schedule, so I never got to spend time with the baby for almost the first 1 year when I was pumping, because I was pumping so much to make sure my supply was high. And in fact, I did have a very good supply and I was able to stock up my entire freezer, which helped us almost get through those 12 months. But after that 1 year, that's when I started spending more time with the baby and doing more things. And in those initial phases where you have to express colostrum, which is a thick yellow milk that comes right after birth, for that, hand expression is the best, then pumping. So make sure you learn hand expression technique a bit. And this hand expression technique you can also employ when you're pumping, because hand expression helps you express more milk overall. So it also helps you keep up your supply. And as mothers, whatever you do and how much ever you prepare, there will still be a lot of things that are unexpected and that you're not aware of. And that is the reason being a mother is both a tough as well as an enjoyable experience, because you're learning and implementing everything at the same time. And also, if you decide you want to wash pump pads at work, try to keep a baby dishwashing liquid as well as a drying rack at work so that it's easy for you to wash those pump pads. To avoid friction, I used to use oil on the flange. And another thing which most people forget is when it comes to keeping up your supply, it's very important that you eat at least 500 extra calories when you're breastfeeding. So every day you have to make sure that you eat at least 500 calories extra. But again, that doesn't mean 500 calories from any source. You have to eat 500 calories from good sources of food like beans, a lot of green leafy vegetables. And also don't forget the importance of hind milk. That is the milk that comes at the very end when you're pumping. So say for example you're pumping for 15 minutes, so in the last 2 minutes that's when you will see that thick white milk, and that milk is very important because that is the milk which contains the fat and it helps the baby feel full. So make sure when you're expressing milk that you're also collecting the hind milk. So the pump that I've used is a Spectra S2 pump, and if you want a full detailed video on how I use this pump, then please do check my Spectra S2 breast pump video. So also to stay motivated, I used to follow this lady Pump Mama Pump in Instagram. So if you're someone who's on your pumping journey, then please do follow her. And her content is very encouraging because when you're on pumping journey, it feels like it's never going to end and it's very difficult to just go through that journey. So finding someone who's going through this journey either online or either your friend or someone who is also a new mom, sharing with them, talking to them will really help you relax. And remember, pumping is also breastfeeding. A lot of times people forget that, but breast pumping is also breastfeeding, because breastfeeding means feeding the baby breast milk. It doesn't matter how, either by direct breastfeeding or by exclusive pumping, you can still achieve the same result, which is the breastfeeding. So when you're pumping, also try to keep a bottle of water with you, and that will help you keep up your milk supply, because if you are dehydrated, and then your body will not be able to produce as much milk. And also not just water, drink any kind of fluids like soup or tea or juice, because you still want those 500 extra calories from good sources of food. And don't forget the power of power pumping. If you have not seen my Spectra S2 breast pump video, in there I provide specific details on how to do power pumping. But again, I'll explain you at high level. Power pumping is very helpful for working mothers. So over the week, they're pumping regularly, but on weekends, in order to increase the milk supply, you can do what is called as power pumping. So in this process, first you pump for 20 minutes, then you rest for 10 minutes, then you pump for 10 minutes, then you rest for 10 minutes, and then you pump for 10 minutes again. So it's like three pumping sessions with two breaks in the middle. So this mimics the cluster feeding of the baby, and this will help you boost up your milk supply. Breastfeeding is a big source of stress, but again, the most important thing to do is what works for you, your family, and your child. And the most important thing is you and your child here, because you are in that direct relationship, and do what works for you both. And in case you forget your breast pump pads at home, yes, it can be very stressful, and sometimes you may not want to drive home all the way. Then alternatively, you can go is you can stop by Walmart or Target or any CVS pharmacy. Most of these places do carry pump pads, so you can buy those pieces. I also mentioned that in US, breast pump is considered as a medical device, so you should be able to carry this on flights with no additional charge. So you do need to talk to the TSA agent and let them know that you're carrying breast milk. Usually they'll be screened separate from your luggage. And also in flights, you'll be able to pump on your seat as well as in the bathroom. So the best way to do is take a seat in the very end, and then you cover yourself with a nursing cover, and then you put on the pump. And if you want specific instructions on pumping schedule and how to pump, please do check that in my Spectra S2 breast pump video as well. So how to label your stored milk in storage bags. So first thing you always have to remember is to wash your hands before pumping, and then you store milk in the bottle or the storage bags. So as soon as you save them in the bottle or the storage bags, first thing, label them with date, time, and baby's name in case the baby is going to daycare and if you plan to give this milk to them. And then cool milk immediately as soon as you express the milk, and store them in the refrigerator, or you can also use a cooler with ice packs in case you have to transport them from work to the home. And always store breast milk per the feeding size, and generally it's always a good idea to not save more than 6 ounces for one sitting. But initial phases when they're not consuming as much, you can start as low as 2 ounces. You can save them in 2 ounce increments and then go all the way up until 6 or 8 ounces, but you should not go beyond that, because in one sitting they may not be able to drink beyond 8 ounces even when they're like 1 year old. But again, it depends on the baby itself. So if this is different for you, you can see what works for your baby and how much your baby is consuming in one sitting. And always remember, when it comes to breast pumping, baby is your best pump. There is no better pump than baby. But however, breast pumping is in cases where you are unable to establish during breastfeeding. In my case, I had latching issues and other issues because of which I was not able to establish breast pumping.